A PDF of additional material accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents The House Your Stars Built, A Guide to the 12 Astrological Houses and Your Place in the Universe by Rachel Stuart-Haas. Read by Esther White. Introduction. Hello. Buckle up. Keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the ride at all times, because we're off on a journey into the fascinating and, let's face it, rather intimidating field of astrology. But never fear, I'll be here as a guide to make this trip way less mysterious and hopefully a lot of fun. By the time you've finished listening, not only will you have acquired the skills to read your own chart and have a great party trick up your sleeve to impress your friends and family, but you'll have learned a heck of a lot about yourself. From how you love, to what you long for, to career fulfillment, to the most nurturing forms of self-care. Our stars invite us to pause, turn inward, and see what paths the universe is nudging us to follow. I don't need to tell you that these are stressful times. We compare ourselves to high standards set by perfectly curated Instagram feeds and glossy magazine pages. Workplaces are rarely secure, and turnover is commonplace. Articles about climate change, social inequality, political bad behavior, disease, and natural disaster dominate the headlines and keep us from falling asleep at night. Technology is evolving at a dizzying pace. While we are more globally connected than at any other point in human history, we often feel lonely. It can often seem impossible to build meaningful, deep connections in a right-swipe society. Negative stress affects our lives almost daily. It can impact our physical and mental health in so many ways and has become so prevalent that we tend to just accept it as a normal, everyday part of life. We all have ways to get through the day, to keep our heads and hopes high. Besides getting more sleep, taking some deep breaths, and eating a few pieces of chocolate, I've got another tool to keep in your self-care toolkit, a way to find solace and a guide to living your best life. The stars. Yep, good old-fashioned astrology. To practice astrology is to have a huge advantage when it comes to facing fears or periods of uncertainty, creating goals, and shaping your future. Forewarned is forearmed, and trust me on this, gaining insight on how the universe affects you can be a rewarding emotional process. Studying astrology brings greater self-knowledge and affirms not only who you are, but who you are evolving into. Most people find reading their charts not just insightful, but also deeply therapeutic. Astrology can point you toward the best time to go for that raise, to take a chance on love, or to simply make time for yourself. You always have free will, of course, but aligning yourself with the energy of the cosmos will give you a leg up on life decisions, big or small. Perhaps even more importantly and profoundly, it will help you get to know yourself better. You spend every one of your trips around the sun with yourself. Self-reflection, self-acceptance, self-improvement. These are valuable gifts. The gifts of the stars. So, what exactly is astrology? Quite simply, astrology is the study of planets, stars, and seasons and their impact on humans here on Earth. Learning to interpret this information is a lot like learning another language, and it can feel overwhelming at first. But as you learn to decode the astral codes, a door opens up, granting you a backstage pass to the profound influence of the universe on our earthly lives. Instead of learning how to conjugate verbs or say, "Where is the bathroom?" this ancient language will help you take part in the primordial conversation between the stars, moon, and planets of our universe. Our goal in practicing astrology is to become fluent in the way celestial bodies interact with one another, so that we can interpret how these synergies shape major events in history and our personal journeys. As far as we can tell, humans have always searched for meaning in the night sky. As evidenced by early cave drawings, even ancient civilizations recognized cycles in the stars and planets and used those patterns to help with quotidian tasks like farming and navigation, as well as guides for spiritual expression. But the roots of modern astrology can be found in ancient Babylonia. Those clever Babylonians noodled out that the constellations appear to move, and that these movements worked well as a celestial time gauge if divided into distinguishable and equal segments. Even better, they gave each segment a memorable name. Can we say early branding? Then the Greeks, who were always a little extra, took the foundation provided by the Babylonians and built on it. One of their contributions was providing us with the term for the ring of constellations first identified by the Babylonians, which they labeled Zodiacos Kyklos, or literally, animal circle. Zodiac. Think of the zodiac as a belt around the heavens. It extends a little bit north and south of the path the sun appears to take around the earth over the course of the year. The stars, and constellations, contained within this belt are divided into 12 segments and compose the 12 signs. While the Greeks were instrumental in helping define the zodiac, over in Egypt, a mathematician named Ptolemy published a book called Tetrabiblos, which basically took all the cool things people were learning about the stars and their impact on human life, including planets, zodiac signs, houses, and aspects, and put it on paper, or shall we say, papyrus. The Romans, never ones to resist putting their own stamps on things, gave the names to the zodiac houses, Capricorn, Taurus, Cancer, and so on, we still use today. After the fall of the Roman Empire, astrology fell out of favor in the West, but took off in the great Islamic empires and East Asia, where it is still practiced today. In the Middle Ages, astrology again became common in Western civilization. From professors to popes, the greatest minds in Europe applied themselves to the study of the planets. Astrology became a point of contemplation for great thinkers like Carl Jung and others in the 19th and 20th centuries and ubiquitous in newspaper columns. Who didn't consult, or watch their parents consult, their horoscope in the local paper before heading off to work or school in the 1980s and 1990s. And these days, astrology apps are among the most popular in the App Store. As far as I'm concerned, this is absolutely fabulous, and the fact you're here listening to these words is to join the ranks of many wise and/or famous folks who have looked to the stars to help them accomplish their goals. Astrology isn't just for millennials and new agey folks. Many celebrities and important historical figures have turned to the stars over the years. Let's take a quick look at a few notable people who have used astrology to inform their strategic decision-making and life choices. Here are five examples that might surprise you. J.P. Morgan, banking tycoon. Mr. Morgan once famously said that millionaires don't need astrologers, but billionaires do. He thought that there was much more to the market than lucky timing, and often used astrologers to help guide him at critical junctures in his businesses and investments. Nancy Reagan, First Lady. After the attempted assassination of President Reagan in 1981, Nancy sought out the services of a notable astrologer whom she consulted in secret. It's rumored that many of Reagan's political decisions were timed astrologically, despite his denials. Ben Franklin, founding father. In 1776, Benjamin Franklin deliberately changed the date members of the Continental Congress signed America's Declaration of Independence. It was originally supposed to occur on July 2nd, but he pushed to change the date to the 4th to take advantage of the friendlier astrological alignments on that day. So thank the stars next year while you chomp your hot dog while watching the fireworks. Princess Diana, Princess of Wales. Princess Diana openly consulted psychics and astrologers throughout her adult life. According to her personal astrologer, the practice gave her control in a high-profile life that often felt anything but. Charles de Gaulle, French general/president. After World War II, de Gaulle enlisted the assistance of a major in the French army who was skilled in astrological charts. He consulted the man regularly until losing power after a series of political decisions the astrologer had strongly cautioned against. Human beings need to feel like we are part of something larger than ourselves, to be connected to the great and mighty universe. Many of us crave a way to make sense out of our lives and to see ourselves.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.